What we really mean is how much did the vaccine reduce the risk of becoming infected or developing disease?
Dr. Daniel Karitzkis is chief of the Division of Infectious Diseases at Brigham and Women's Hospital. That risk reduction varies among the companies with authorized coronavirus vaccines and candidates. And while overall efficacy also varies by geography, in the U.S., Moderna's vaccine is 94.1% effective at preventing disease, Pfizer's option 95%. Johnson & Johnson's vaccine candidate is lower at 72%.
These vaccines are all much more effective than what we are used to seeing with the flu vaccine.
The flu vaccine is around 40 to 60% effective when it's well matched to the most circulated virus, according to the CDC. When it comes to coronavirus vaccines, direct efficacy comparisons may not be helpful. Dr. Karitzkis points out Johnson & Johnson's is a different type of vaccine, and it was tested at a different time.
If you look at protection from severe disease, and severe disease means being sick enough to be hospitalized, then all of the vaccines have shown really high and similarly high rates of protection.
Also consider this. Dr. Ashish Jha, dean of the Brown University School of Public Health, recently tweeted this chart showing of the thousands of people vaccinated as part of the clinical trials, across the board, none were hospitalized or died from COVID-19, and no one died from the vaccine itself.
All of these vaccines protect against severe disease, and when used together, meaning if we can deploy these vaccines, whichever ones they are, in as many people as we can throughout the population, they will bring the pandemic to a close.
Now, there are still questions. It's not clear the vaccine stopped transmission of the virus. The recent data from AstraZeneca is promising. And when it comes to the virus variants we're hearing so much about, early results do suggest that all three candidates offer protection, though they may be slightly less effective.